Hey guys, it's your Faith Girl wishing you a very special, festive, and peaceful Mother's Day. If you found my channel from Instagram, thank you so much for taking the time to tune in. Please feel free to subscribe to the Faith Rocks YouTube channel. I come to you with just tips about motherhood, parenting, lifestyle, makeup, hair, faith. The Lord has really just placed mothers on my heart today in a very intimate way. Mothers especially in particular who are mourning. Mother's Day is a happy time. It's a special time that many of us take for granted, because I know for some people it's a day of mourning, it's a day of grief, it's a day where you're just trying to get through the day because your heart may be heavy. Because maybe you've lost a mom, or maybe you've even lost a child. And I just want to reach out to you today to let you know that God has a plan to restore you. I'm gonna pray for you. And I'm not basing this on my words of my heart. This is the word of God. Isaiah 61 and 3 says, "To all who mourn in Israel, he will give a crown of beauty for ashes, a joyous blessing instead of mourning, festive praise instead of despair. In their righteousness, they will be like great oaks that the Lord has planted for his own glory." Did you know that Jesus Christ specializes in turning your pain into power? That when you partake in him in the fellowship of your sufferings, that is where you enter into the presence of God, where he's waiting to meet you. That no matter what you've gone through, what loss you've experienced, no matter how horrific or desperate you may be feeling, know that God is yearning and waiting for you to draw close to him, so that he can completely heal and restore your heart. He's not in the business of doing a partial surgery or a partial healing. God wants to give you 100% complete restoration and wholeness. So God is wanting and has promised to give you beauty for ashes. For all the sleepless nights you've had, all the tears you cried, God is going to exchange that for beauty. And he's doing that. You may feel unstable. He is going to make you like a great oak that the Lord has planted for his own glory. How awesome and marvelous is that? God is going to stabilize you. He's going to stabilize your moods. He's going to stabilize your emotions. He is going to give you the glory so that you can continue with your life, being the mother that he's called you to be, being the wife that he's called you to be, being excellent in your profession still, regardless of what you had to go through. So if you would, just pray with me for a moment. Father God, oh God, we thank you so much for this day. We thank you for this man-made holiday, but it is a day. Every day is a day that you have made, Lord God. I just ask that you would give them beauty for ashes today, Father God. People's hearts are heavy, Father God, because they have lost a mother, they've lost a child, Lord God, and they don't understand why, Lord God. I ask, Lord God, that you would give them peace in the midst of their questions, in the midst of their confusion, in the midst of why me and why did this have to happen, Father God. I just, God, ask that you would give them peace, Lord God. Your word says that there is a season for everything under the sun, everything under the heavens, Father God. Loss, even loss, Father God, is not too hard for you, Father God, because you defeated death, Lord God. Death could not keep you, Father God. So I ask that you would bestow that same resurrecting power, Lord God, of healing upon anyone watching this that is mourning and grieving loss today, Father God. Lord, I ask that you would give them glory, Father God, for their pain, Lord God, that you would replace every sleepless night, Lord God, with joy, Lord. You said that weeping endures for a night, but joy comes in the morning, Father God. Oh, touch right now, Father God. Go in their home, Father God, and fill it with your love. Fill it with your grace. Fill it with your power, Lord. Remove the guilt. remove the confusion, Lord. Remove the emptiness and the brokenness and all the unanswered questions, Father God, because you have come to give them life. You have come to give it more abundantly, Father God. So I ask, Lord God, that you would lead, God. You would lead the heavy-hearted and the broken-hearted on your path, Lord God, of abundance, Lord God. That you would replace their pain and that you would give them power, Father God. That you would give them power, Lord God, to see things the way you see them, God. That you would give them power, God, to know that this walk in this life is temporary, Father God, and that if we maintain our relationship with you, God, there is an afterlife, Father God, that we will spend eternity with you, God, where we will be with and see all of our loved ones, Father God, all of those who've gone before us, Father God, that we would be with them, Father God, that we would see them again, God. Give and bestow, God, your everlasting hope, God, your eternal peace, Father God. Just shower any woman watching this, Father God, just with your presence, God. Shower them, Lord God, with your hope, God. Shower them, Father God, with the healing and complete healing and wholeness that they need, God, to continue on, Father God. I'm praying for the woman right now, God, that doesn't want to keep going on, God, that doesn't know how to keep moving forward, God, because of the pain, because of the loss, Lord God. Let them know that there's healing today, Father God. Let them know, God, that joy is coming, God. Let them know that this season of grief is going to pass, God. Teach them the lesson, God. Give them the strength. Give them the endurance. Give them the perseverance, Lord God, to keep going on, to keep fighting the good fight of faith, Father God. Oh, Lord, I ask all of these things in your son's name, Jesus Christ. Amen. Oh, gosh. I'm so thankful for the power of prayer, guys. I want you to know that I'm praying for you, that I'm here to intercede for you. Look in the detail box below, the informational box below, for my email address if you need prayer, if you need a word of encouragement. Let me know what you need. Myself and the Ministry of Faith Rocks is here to support you, here to pray with you and for you. So don't be ashamed, and know that Jesus Christ is always there to mend the brokenhearted. That was his purpose. So I love you, and I just pray more than anything for peace for you on this day, that you can just meditate on the promises of God and that you can feel peace and hope and love and restoration. Thank you for praying with me, and keep tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not, and share Faith Rocks with a friend or a mother in desperate need of a faith lift. God bless you.